ち上げられました。
We have a liftoff of the H2B launch vehicle number 7 with Kounotori 7 aboard from the JAXA Kanagashima Space Center.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, the Japanese HTV-7 cargo vehicle arrived at the International Space Station. The supply ship launched Saturday, September 22nd from Japan, loaded with more than 5 tons of new science and supplies destined for the crew. The vehicle was captured by astronauts on station on Thursday, September 27th. In the vehicle were spare parts and experiments, including an investigation into the effect of microgravity on bone marrow and new batteries for the space station. One of the critical payloads inside the HTV-7 was the Life Sciences Glove Box. The new facility will enable research to advance human health on Earth and in space. Roughly the size of a large fish tank, the Life Sciences Glove Box is officially the largest flight hardware ever launched in a soft-stowed configuration in which the equipment is packed securely in protective foam. The glove box will be transferred in the Japanese Kibo module, where up to 2 crew members can conduct 1 or more experiments simultaneously. This versatile facility not only will help us better protect human explorers on long voyages into deep space, but it also could aid medical and scientific advances benefiting the whole world.
Ready? Ready! Look at the horizon! I'm looking!
NASA's Josh Cassada and Boeing astronaut Chris Ferguson went through water survival training at NASA's Neutral Buoyancy Laboratory. This is just one form of preparation as astronauts train towards the first crewed launches on spacecraft from Boeing and SpaceX. As always, head over to nasa.gov/commercialcrew for all of the latest updates from this exciting new chapter in human spaceflight. This week's question is about communication. Amelia asks, how often do the astronauts have contact with their family or friends, and is it complicated? Communications between space and Earth have improved greatly in the years since Apollo, Mir, and even the early months of the space station. Back then, astronauts couldn't contact their families easily. Today, during their free time, they have access to an internet protocol telephone. To use this, they can dial a number on a laptop computer, and with the help of an antenna and satellite system, they can speak directly with their families. They can also send messages by email. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround, and tune in to NASA TV on October 2nd as we wrap up the year of education on station. Watch astronaut and former classroom teacher Ricky Arnold answer questions on social media using the hashtag #TeacherOnBoard live from the International Space Station. We'll see you next week.